Finally, the day has come. We're going to start my planted tank build series. Now, I know many of you guys have been waiting a tremendous amount of time for this, and some have even grown frustrated with a lot of the teaser photos I've been posting on Facebook and Instagram over the past few months. Or have been calling me out on some of the reflections in other aquariums saying that you can see the planted tank. And I gotta tell you this, I know that those reflections were there. I made sure they were there. But I did all of this for a simple reason. One, by showing you guys some reflections or doing some teaser photos, it just ensures that I stay committed to this build and I've gotta show it to you one way or the other, whether I succeed or whether I fail. And I believe both are equally important. And I gotta say, I had an equal amount of failures as well as success with this planted tank. Second reason why it's taken so long is far more obvious. Plants take a long time to grow. What my envision here was to show you a planted tank from beginning till end in a very short amount of time. And given that we are on a hobbyist level, we don't start out with massive, copious amounts of plants. We start out with a few clippings or maybe a few clumps of plants and we have to propagate or grow them from that. And that's exactly what I did. So I'm going to be able to show you right from the beginning into a lush planted tank, which it is right now. Now, in the light of full disclosure, I have not set up a planted tank build for over 10 years. And even at that point, it was more so some aquariums with a few live plants. Some were successful, most were not. So I am absolutely stepping out of my comfort zone with this. And then of course there's the do-it-yourself aspect to setting up a planted tank. Many of you want do-it-yourself alternatives to a lot of the equipment available in the aquarium hobby. And I have to point out that I've done a tremendous amount of planted tank devices and equipment over the years, but a lot of my older videos tend to get forgotten. So there's a tremendous amount of planted tank aquarium projects coming up soon. With that said, let's move on to the build. Today I want to show you how I built the aquarium. Now, as an ongoing theme for a lot of the aquariums that I've recently built, you guys will remember, out of the last 375 gallon tank build, there was a tremendous amount of scrap acrylic left over. With some of it, we built the office aquarium. With others, we built the 15 gallon nano tank. But before I built those, I focused on building the planted tank. Now, because this is scrap acrylic from the 375, it means that I'm working with 3/4 inch cell cast acrylic. Now, what that means is, depending on the dimensions I chose to go for the planted tank, I can have a rimless planted tank. I decided I'd build a cube aquarium, which in the long run, given the scape that I really wanted to have, was probably the worst decision I could have made for this build. However, I made it work. To start out, I cut the acrylic up into the dimensions that I would need these pieces to be. I needed a bottom piece of 20 by 20 inches, a front and back piece that were 20 by 18 inches, and then two sides that were 18 and a half by 18 inches. And if you couldn't guess it by now, the tank, or the cube planted tank, is going to be 20 by 20 by 18 tall, holding about 30 gallons, which is probably the average size of most planted tanks starting out to be. Now, after cutting the acrylic up, a lot of the times I like to put it together and hold it together with some clamps just to make sure everything fits. After ensuring everything is cut to the right dimensions, I prepare the edges of the acrylic. Now, I'm probably not going to jump into great detail on how to build an acrylic aquarium because the last few tanks that I built, I've already done that. So we'll just focus on the important part. After fitting the acrylic together, I prepared the edges, ensuring that they were smooth. Then I peeled back some of the protective tape. Now, as a tip, if you ever peel back too much, you can kind of protect the exposed acrylic with some painter's tape. Now, if you don't know, we peel back the tape simply to be able to have access to the seams and be able to actually see what we're doing. It also ensures that none of the protective paper gets stuck in the seams or any acrylic cement gets on it and creates a mess. The protective paper is actually stuck with an adhesive similar to painter's tape. After the acrylic is prepared, it's now ready to go together. Now, given the fact that I'm building a cube aquarium, it doesn't really matter which side you put on first, because no matter which way you turn it, it's going to be 20 inches wide. However, a lot of the times I like the front panel to be a full panel of acrylic with the seams on the inside. So I started with the front panel laying down and placed the side panel on top of it, holding it together with some plywood forms that I created. Now, because this is 3/4 inch cell cast acrylic, we use the pin method of cementing it together. There's actually about 3 or 4 different methods of cementing acrylic, including the pin method I'm going to show you, the capillary method, the brush method, as well as the dipping method. The first two is typically what we use the most. And when it comes to anything over a half inch thick in acrylic, we move towards the pin method, simply because the cement can work its way all the way through. So with the forms holding the acrylic in place and ensuring that it's upright and square for me, I place the clamps on it and have them ready to clamp down. Then I place some very thin pins every 12 inches. You can use a number of different types of pins, but I like to use the pins with a little bit of a head on it so I have something to grip when I pull them out. I then take some Weld-On 4, which is a water-thin acrylic cement, and put it into an applicator bottle with needle. I squirt some in between the seam, and wait about 60 seconds. Now you might notice that at times if you go too quickly, you can actually squirt in some air bubbles. So you want to make sure there's no air in the syringe first and you take your time. With that said, if you do get some air bubbles, don't worry about it. Still wait the 60 seconds. During that 60 seconds or even up to 90 seconds, the cement is going to do its job. It's going to soften the acrylic up enough so that when you remove the pins and tighten the clamps, it squeezes the acrylic together. And because of that, it also squeezes out all of the air bubbles, giving you a very clear seam. Once the acrylic hardens again, you now have one seam fused together on a molecular level. And that's actually how this cement works. When you apply it to acrylic, it softens the acrylic and then the cement actually evaporates. Now, if you have two pieces of softened acrylic and fuse them together at the same time, waiting for it to harden, you end up with one piece of acrylic. And if done right, you can end up with a beautiful seam. Now, because this is a relatively smaller aquarium, you don't have to wait too long, typically about an hour before you move on to the next seam. After an hour, the seam has almost fully dried, but it's not fully cured. And because it's a small tank when you're moving it around, you're not putting a tremendous amount of stress on the seams. Then you essentially do the identical thing to the other side. After that panel, you'll end up with a U-shaped tank. And at this point, we flip that over, put the other panel underneath of it, and go ahead cementing it again. Now, because the span of acrylic is relatively short, and we're using some thick acrylic, we don't have to brace the tank from bowing like we had to do in previous builds. Now, at this point, with all four sides together, the rest is relatively easy. Now, as long as you put it together square and true, all you have to do is cement this to the bottom panel. But in order to get your clamps up underneath of it, you'll have to prop up that bottom panel under a little bit of wood or whatever else you can find that will allow you to still get the clamps underneath the tank. And then of course, once again, set your pins, inject the cement, wait about 60 seconds, pull the pins, and set the clamps down in place. Now, one of the best things about building an acrylic aquarium is that you can use a lot of the tools you use on wood on an acrylic aquarium. So for example, if you have sanders or a router or a table saw or anything like that, you can use all of those on acrylic as long as you have the right blades. For me, a lot of the times I make the panels slightly longer than I need them, usually only by a millimeter or two. This just allows me a little room for error. Plus the fact that a little bit of the softened acrylic squeezes out from the seams. To clean that up, I grab my router and route it all off, giving me a perfect aquarium. Now with this tank, I decided to do something that I've been wanting to do for a while, and that is round out the edges of the tank. Again, grab my router and a 3/4 inch beveling bit. Basically all this is going to do is shave off the corners of the tank and round them out. I did all four corners because again, this is a cube tank. It doesn't really have a front or side or back, regardless of which way you want to look at it. So doing all four corners makes sure that I can position this whatever way I'd like. Now all that's left is polishing the acrylic. Now because we have some rounded corners, you're really going to see the difference. At first, you can't even see through them. It actually looks pretty horrible. So I took some fine grit sandpaper and sanded them down as much as I could, and then took some Novus polishing cream and polished them out to be clear as the rest of the aquarium. Now all that's left really is to remove the protective tape, exposing a brand new cube aquarium just begging to be set up as a planted tank. So that's the tank. It's 18 inches tall, 20 inches wide, 20 inches long, holding about 30 gallons of water. Next week, I'm going to show you how I built the stand. So if you're not subscribed and that's something you want to stay tuned for, make sure you do so you don't miss it. Anyways, I hope that you guys enjoyed today's video. If not, join me next Sunday for part 2 of the Planted Tank Build Series.